Namaste. Welcome to Happiness Yoga. Today we'll discuss about back pain, all the musculoskeletal aches. Why this back pain happens? Because of our sedentary lifestyle. We don't want to sit up from the sofa. We don't want to stand up from the chair. We don't want to do any kind of exercises. Even sitting on the chair in the office throughout the day, we don't get up. We don't do our shoulder or neck exercise. Ma'am, what happened when we watch TV after the dinner? Everybody in our house, after dinner, we keep watching TV lying down on the couch or lying down on the bed. Let us see how we see. Ma'am, can you show?
Yes.
Like this. Keep on changing the channels with the remote. Don't care to sit up. And then what happens? This is the cervical area, the upper seven vertebrae. It's called cervical region. Hunchback, lower back. Pain, the ache start. Ma'am, can you please sit up? Thank you. So this way, because of our wrong habits, we generate the pain day by day. We don't go outside to play the games. We don't play sports, do we? If you don't go to play volleyball or the football, soccer, swimming, jogging, running, if you don't do any kind of exercises, ultimately you end up stiffening of your joints. Gradually, the rigidity will increase. Ultimately, what will happen? You will end up in the obesity. Once the obesity comes, there will be lots of other complications in the body. There are a few flexibility exercises, few asana, which can help us. Few flexibility exercises, ma'am will teach us how to do.
Okay.
We'll both do it together for you. We'll do few counts, 1, 2, 3. But you will have to practice more. There are few flexibility exercises and few asanas suggested in the yoga study. Can we start with a few flexibility exercises?
Sure, sir. First of all, shoulder exercise.
Okay.
Now, inhaling up, exhaling down. Inhaling up, exhaling down. Inhaling up, exhaling down. Last time, inhaling up, exhaling down. Now rotation back to front.
We'll do only few counts for you, but you have to do it at least 10 counts, maybe 20 counts, as per your body capacity allows you to do. Now reverse.
And relax. Now both the hands on your shoulder. And rotation back to front. Whenever you come front, touch your elbows. Just observe your each and every movement. Reverse. And relax. Now stand up on your knees. Both the hands in front of your body and rotation. Make a big circle. Don't fold your elbows. Sorry. Reverse. Reverse and relax. Now sit on your Vajrasana, asanas. Now neck movement. Look left. Look right. Reverse. 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 And reverse. And relax. Now bend your knee left side. Reverse. Reverse. And reverse. And relax. Now, sir, can you show
them? Yeah, we can also show them Gomukhasana. Gomukhasana is very beneficial for the shoulder, for the cervical problem. If you have frozen shoulder, Gomukhasana is very helpful. Gomukhasana can be performed sitting in Vajrasana or even in Guru Asana. Today, we'll see Diamond Pose, the Vajrasana. Just come in the center. Okay, here in Gomukhasana, you have to lift your left hand up, right hand up, left hand from the back, and try to make a clutch of the fingers like the ma'am is doing. See, you have to take care that the elbow should come in the center of your head. Very simple. If you are not able to make a clutch of the fingers, not to worry. You can start with, you can keep the napkin or the hanky like this. Ma'am, can you please show them? If they are not able to make a clutch, you can hold the napkin like this. Then gradually bring your both the hands nearer. One day you will be able to make the clutch of your fingers. Right? Okay, gently release. You can also do this with the another hand. So these are the few exercises which your shoulder and neck gets benefited. Now let us see some important postures. Actually, for the back pain or for this kind of musculoskeletal problems, we have a range of postures. So many different variations, different postures, starting from Katiuttanasana, the Setu Bandhasana, like the bridge pose. We also have Matsyasana, the fish pose, different variations of Matsyasana. We can do Paschimottanasana. We can also perform different variations of Naukasana, the boat pose, the inverse boat pose. In the inverse boat pose, we keep our abdomen on the ground and we lift our hands and legs up in the air. But today we'll see only three or four of more importance. We can start with the simple one, Pavan Muktasana. Pavan Muktasana, it can also be done in three different ways. We'll see all the three different ways. If you are suffering from the cervical problem, you are not supposed to lift your head up. Let us see how it has to be performed. For Pavan Muktasana, we have to lie down on our back. Legs together, hands by the side of the thighs. Gently bend your both the knees, bring your knees on the chest. Now with the support of your both hands, hold your knees. Try to make a clutch of your elbows. With one hand, hold the elbow of another hand. With the right hand, hold the left elbow. Left hand, hold the right elbow, like ma'am is doing. But if you are obese, you may not be able to hold like this. In that case, you can hold your both the knees like this. Make a clutch of the fingers. You can also hold your calf bone or the knees. This also you can do, no problem. Now, if you have severe cervical pain or severe lumbosacral pain, just keep like this. Stay here. Both the feet pointed outside. Stay for a few times. Few seconds. Stay here. Keep breathing. Long, deep breathing. Eyes closed. Enjoy the posture. Gently open your eyes. Now, if you are not suffering from the cervical area, cervical problem, you can lift your head up. First inhale, exhale on the way. Lift your chest up, head up, and bring your forehead to your knees. Pavan Muktasana. Apart from giving benefits to the spine, it also reduces obesity. It also improves the efficiency of our digestive system. It also helps removing the constipation. Very beneficial, very simple to perform. Again, if you are obese and not able to touch your forehead to your knee, what will you do? Try to touch your chin to the knee, like this. This is more comfortable. It's comfortable you can do this. If you can't do this, no worry. Just release your head down on the ground. Try to push your both the knees on your stomach, on your abdomen. Then, while coming back, Gently release out of both the hands. Gently bring your both the feet on the ground, just near your hips, and gently release your stretch your legs. And then you can relax in Shavasana, the corpse pose. Simple posture, so many benefits. Another posture we'll see today is Matsyasana. Matsyasana can be performed in three different variants, in the lotus, in the diamond, and the simple one. Ma'am, which one would you like to do?
Vajrasana.
Vajrasana, oh, ma'am always prefers the tougher one. Okay, for Vajrasana, sit up in diamond, the Vajrasana. Then gently bring your both the palms behind your hip, make an L shape behind your hip, right elbow down, left elbow down, gently lie down on your back. These are together, these are on the ground. Looks very simple, but while we do, it's not that much simple. But no problem, with regular practice, you will also be able to do good Matsyasana like ma'am is doing. Now, we'll bring both the hands by the side of the ears. Here, the fingers are pointed to the shoulder. Give pressure on the hands, lift your chest up and turn your head towards your back and try to touch the crown of the head on the ground. See the arch? This arch you have to make. This posture very much beneficial for cervical or the upper back pain, hunchback pain, and also the lower back pain. Do not perform this posture if your doctor has advised not to bend your neck back. Otherwise, it's good posture for all the spinal problems, I mean all the back pain related problems. Now, how will we come back? Before coming back, I would like to point out one more thing. This is the posture where our chest gets more expansion. So our lungs get more expansion, it gets more oxygen, very much powerful. It also becomes more efficient. How to come back? Gently, the way we went up, we have to come back. Bring up both the hands, pressure, lift the head up, release the head, bring both the hands by the side of the thighs with the support of the hands, gently sit up. After sitting up, you can release your Vajrasana. Can I show this cobra pose and bow pose for you?
Okay, no problem.
Okay.
Be ready for Bhujangasana, the cobra posture. Forehead touch to the ground, both the hands near to your chest and toes pointed to the ground. Now, gently inhale and lift your head up, chest up, up to the navel. Both the hands half folded near your chest, look up. Expand your chest maximum. Don't separate your toes and heels too. And now, gently come back. While exhaling, gently come back. The other postures for back pain, the bow posture, Dhanurasana. Now, both the legs together, both the hands together. Gently fold your both legs from the knees. Hold your ankles and just lift up. Now, beautiful bow posture. Now, gently come back. Release your legs and turn to the left and please be seated.
The bow posture which you have just seen has so many other advantages, like it involves all the body joints. So, if there is some false gases here in the joints, it releases it. So, we can save ourselves from the arthritis. If you have arthritis, if you regularly practice bow posture, it will help you a lot. Also, it can reduce the obesity or the tummy fat. Bow posture has so many other advantages. Same way, Bhujangasana, the cobra pose which we have just seen, in the cobra pose, it also controls our hunger. We can reduce our hunger. We can reduce the obesity. Of course, it is helpful for the back, but it also has so many other benefits. Friends, we can also see so many different postures like Shashakasana, once again, very much helpful for musculoskeletal problem. Yoga Mudra, sitting in Vajrasana, it removes the constipation. So once again, constipation is also one of the important cause for the back pain. If our stomach is healthy, if it is free of constipation, if our digestion is good, then we won't have side effect like back pain. If we do it regularly every day, we can definitely get rid of these kind of simple problems. Back pain, not a serious, not non-curable, but of course it needs your attention, lots of attention. We have a set of master keys. Relax. Ma'am, can we share with them?
Yes, of course.
Okay. Repeat with us. How can we do yoga practice? This is the set of master key for doing yoga practice.
Every day. Regularly, scientifically, systematically, without fail, with all interest. Nothing is impossible.
If we remove I am from impossible, it becomes possible. Remove I, remove ego, everything becomes possible. Thank you.
Stay healthy, stay happy. Namaste.